Back to my channel. Today, I'm going to tell you a story about when I did get robbed at Mandeville. But before I go into the story, I just want you to like, share, subscribe, and press the notification button. Hold on for this. I went to university in Mandeville. I went to Northern Caribbean University. I went down there from 2008. When I first went down there, I was living in Christiana. And then I moved into Mandeville. So I was renting this place. You know, when you go to school at Mandeville, you know, come from down there. So you have to either rent somewhere off campus or you pay for boarding and stuff like that. So me did rent off campus. I'm a big man. I'm not on the campus. Anyway, so one evening in 2009, I don't remember the name of the community that I was living in, but it's somewhere off Manchester Road, I think. Somewhere, I don't remember. And we were home, so it was about 5 of us that lived in the house, 5 girls, 3 single rooms and 1 room for 2 persons. So one night, you know, most persons were cooking and everything, and I think the time did hot. One of them time there, you never saw cold, and it never hot, but you know, you open your door or your window or so. So, we didn't know everybody a cook and a chat and enjoy themselves from your room back to your room to the kitchen and stuff like that. So I was in my room and I think I wanted to use the bathroom. But me door did open at the time. Me no remember if me locked the door, I forgot. Or me did just push it up, you know, and go in at the bathroom and come back. And I think me open it back. So honestly, me no remember if me did lock the door or the door did wide open. And then my other roommate beside me too, she did have fair door home at one point. I think she did lock back her door. Yeah. But me can't. Maybe push up it. I think the boat door, they push up it, just never bolt nor key nor nothing. So it did shut. So anyway, we didn't know I was still alive and chat and something. This time now me decides, alright, me I go in the kitchen. So I'm going in the kitchen now and in there I chat for a little bit. My light on or something in my room, light on in my housemate room for the next right beside me or something. So I tell them, so me I go in my room go look for something. People, when I step in the room at home and that son up at the doorway with gun. God, Jesus. Me stand up, you know, dumbstruck, shock. Come and say, right, see that we're going, you know. We're going. So anyway, them say, come. When you come around, I saw, and I'm going to, by this time, now them come around, the rest of my house meet, them start screaming. Beer screaming in the house. And all them are screaming, not saying nothing. I'm not saying anything, I'm not screaming. I'm shocked, I'm dumbstruck. Right, so me did, you know, and me I say, alright, walk up one, you know, walk up one. So everybody has screamed, them get up, everybody. Then them took out one person, and let me tell you this, for the life of me, nobody can tell me something who do it, because so them coming at the house at a 4 room, one out of the front, then you come around, one dead so, my one dead so, and the share room dead so, right? Then put all the way in at the middle room, and take out the girl who live in at the front room. And tell us that them know something about the house. Then take the girl, we live in the front room, and tell us to come. They want her laptop, phone, everything. They might know, you know. Remember, you know, them take out the one where actually living in the room. And I like for them come take somebody where no living in the room. Then take the person who living in the room, carry her in the room, take her laptop, search up her jar, take any money, jewelry, anything where she have. Clean out the room. By this time, now the other one have we in the other room now. Neil Dong. I said, we're not for look pan him. We never, we not see them face, got them face cover up with mask and whatever them have. After gone pine power, take our phone, search up all of the room, them take our laptop, take our phone, take our money, anything them could have find them take. Me did have about $2 in my purse, and them take it. $1, you know, $1, yeah, and them take it. Them take everything. By this time, no, I never all of the dead still. One of the girls, she did gone on for the weekend. So them have the girl running now. We the man search out fear room and everything and I take everything from she. So we know they in the room and the rest of the girl them a ball and something. After a while me they start ball, you know, come here and say, Jesus, I eat this. When I tell the man oh, look on my head in a car, I go look up. No, me can't see them face. Me see him shoes. And for some reason me know the shoes from somewhere. But anyway. Me they don't wanna comply with everything where them say. So when them take the phone now, one of the housemates say, you can't give him back the chip. So me no get afraid to me and say, who she be so fair ask man back for your chip. The man I take away my phone and everything. Cause they know what we call about it. Anyway, the gunman was very nice. Him give back with chip. All the way, give back all the way chip them. Tell us if we kneel down, turn around the face, I wanna for look upon them. Alright, we're gonna look upon them. Them today and them search and them take them for take and this time no start run through my head because me talk ball now. Because me I say, what is this going to happen now? Me left Frankinson come and Mandeville for my mother got here, so me now come back home. Eh? I feel rub me for nothing because them is a prep and the NCU student them. It's like anytime them know say some registration or them know say some something them many know how people come so and y'all come rub students. And we have the money. We have the one little laptop for every school and we have the little phone for talk to a parent and something and they want to take them away. Anyway, them do them rubbing and everything. Them not touch none away. Them not do none away nothing. You say when them gone, the whole of we in the house afraid now, you know. Because we want to come out and we want to call the police. But we must them take out the whole of the phone. But the landlord living at the yard just further down from which part of the house today. So when him come, when them gone, I was like, alright, well, after we call the police now, you know, because we can't just there, so. We did it and wait. And we said, alright, maybe we can go now. And we peep through window, we peep through this. And so we see, say, everything felt clear. The whole we dash out through the house. No shoes, nothing, you know. So the yard have stone and all sorts of sitting upon the ground, you know, gravel and all that, you know, can't joke up in your foot, everything. We don't feel nothing. The whole we tear go down. And the landlord tell him so we just get robbed and if we call the police and all that something. Now the police thing now is the next story. When we call the police, they might tell you say them that have no unit for come do no checks and nothing for you know for find out what go and take fingerprint and all that. So they said then this don't make no sense. Then if me get robbed it don't make sense for call nobody because we not get no help. Anyway, but then I was alright, so we wait until the next day. We had to wait until no, like the landlord care will go out of Mandeville because they say we'll say if we can reach out there. Imagine, suppose we never have a landlord there, suppose we would have reached out of Mandeville for our police station. Anyway, we're at Mandeville police station now and I met the report. So we tell them what going on, what happened, everything. Them tell us say them can't come at the yard at that time because, as we said, they tell you, them say no. Karen did it, say come. Anyway, we did know and get a report and everything, and then we'll go back home. Afraid for go, you know, because we want and you know, paranoid, you know, lock up every minute and all of them something they call, you know, and nobody come in back, and we come rob you again for them, we're not for them rob. So we did it, and we say, all right, but they don't want to stay there again, you know, so everybody looks so. Move, but back into that story, you know. So, them, I think the care, them, they said the care, they are Clarendon for come to the, you know, text and whatever, whatever. So, the person, somebody came, I think them, they have a private care come ask a question and do them check and something. And then we follow up with you for some time until we move from there. Good policeman, you know, check up here till we move and something now. After all of that and the robbery and everything, you know, nobody can tell me, say, me no see the somebody. Because I have a tendency for walk and look down. If I walk and look down, somewhere with me. You know, I get me a walk and I look all over the place and, you know, if I walk and I look down, me look up, you know, come and I go walk and buck up. But, yeah, I just mean that. So, yeah, me a walk and I look down and pass the taxi because the taxi always line off anyway in the town. And people kill my dead. I see the shoes when I see the night. Kill me dead at the same smile, you know. Shot. that black and white shoes there. I see it and I know it says you. But anyway, we moved on and we left the house and all of us lived in separate places. Through the ordeal, it taught me that you have to be strong. Anything can happen to you in your life. Come here, say, look, oh, me left good, good Kingston. Yes, good, good Kingston, because people that tell you, say, they're afraid to come at home because they're going to get robbed and they're afraid of this and that. I mean, live at Kingston. Wow, come go to university when me I was 23. 20 odd years of my life, me live at Kingston. I mean, never get robbed yet. And I'm going to go get robbed. But it was an experience, something to learn from. So I'm not going to forget, because in my life, and nothing like that after, people that were going to my head, can you imagine, need a good data, did a man live for what? Laptop we can buy again, or phone, or something, just because you feel like you need to come rob a house with all girls. Sad. But, and I want to tell her to, you know, used to talk to this man at the time. And when me tell the man we're going or something, the man say, hey, I good to me never come look for you that weekend, the car. You that ear say this and that and whatever. And you know, so after that, he not come back. Like, he make like say, I mean, the people him rob the place and next thing they go come and something go do him. But soon did go find girl. But yeah, that is another story. But yeah, guys, so I was robbed in Mandeville, robbed a phone, laptop, they robbed jewelry, money, anything them think valuable enough for them could I take, them rob it. Big up to all of the girls that mommy used to live with in that house. They are all working now. One is a nurse, one is a marketing executive, I think that's what she does. The other one is a teacher as well, and I think the other one is a teacher too. The other one is a teacher too. I think I did three teachers, are we? And one nurse and one marketing person. Yeah, but in 2 days, those were good times. Good times. I spent 5 years down there, did my degree, and now I'm a teacher, guys. I teach secondary school or high school. So yes, the experience was good. So that's my I got robbed in Mandeville story. Thank you for watching.